Hey, you! I need you to hit that subscribe button. Subscribe.
So what is our heritage?
Right.
What is the black man's heritage? It's not twerking. It's not twerking. It's not doing drugs. It's not alcoholism.
Right.
It's not diabetes. It's not Christmas. It's not Thanksgiving. It's not 4th of July. It's
right.
not birthdays.
Right.
It's not all the things we've learned as slaves in America.
That's right.
Make no mistake. So what is it? What is it? What is the answer? Come on, watch this. The book of Sirach, chapter 24, verse 23. All these things are the book of the covenant of the Most High God. So the notion is the book of the covenant of the Most High God. We call it the Bible today. We call it the Bible. What is the Bible, brother? Come on. Even the law which Moses commanded for inheritance. What is the Bible? Inheritance. What is the black, Hispanic, and Native American man and woman's heritage?
The law which Moses commanded for inheritance unto the congregations of Jacob.
Now, some of us don't understand what our heritage is, but today you're going to learn. Some of us don't know our history, so we don't know what this book has to do with the black man and woman today. We don't know because we don't read, and we're fed lies continually, constantly fed lies.
Right.
In the institutions that we feel like should be teaching us truth, our education system, our church or religious system, all we're learning is lies under both of those institutions.
That's right.
All we're learning is subjugation to the... Go over there with the officer. Yeah, don't leave him by himself. All we're learning is how to be subject as slaves to our oppressor. That's all we're learning. That's it. And it's done with such subtlety today. We don't even recognize that we are still slaves to this day. Give me that Baruch chapter 3, verse 8.
Bring it out.
Let's establish that. Let's establish that. You brothers and sisters, come ask questions. You want to know what your real heritage is? You want to know what the Bible say about who you actually are? Why slavery happened to you? Why a pink man whipped your back on a slave plantation once upon a time? You want to know why? You want to know why we die in the street? You want to know why it's drugs, why we live worse than any other nation on this planet? Come ask. The Bible has the answer. God did not leave us without answers. He gave us answers. We just don't seek him. We don't seek the Lord. Come on, read that.
The book of Baruch, chapter 3, verse 8.
Come on.
Behold, we are yet this day in our captivity, where thou hast scattered us. For a reproach and a curse.
The Bible say we are yet this day in our captivity. We are yet this day in our captivity. Brother with the locks and the gray shirt, do you believe that you're a free man? Or you understand plainly, we are in the land of our captivity. It's okay, I just asked you a question, bro. Right? We don't know that we're slaves to this day. We don't understand that.
Right.
We don't understand that. Read it again.
Behold, we are yet this day in our captivity, where thou hast scattered us for a reproach and a curse to be subject to payment.
So some of y'all might think that y'all free. Well, the Bible say that you are scattered for in captivity if you are subject to payments. Raise your hand if you are not subject to payments. We are all subject to payments. All subject to payments, but guess what? You Hispanics, Native Americans, black man, you were never meant to be on the bottom. You were meant to rule this planet.
Right.
You were created never to die. You were created to be gods on this earth. That's who you actually are.
Right.
And we've fallen so low. That is a hard thing that I just said to some of us.
Right.
That's how low we've fallen. That's how low we've fallen. Read that again.
Behold, we are yet this day in our captivity, where thou hast scattered us for a reproach.
The word reproach means hatred. To reproach something means to hate it. God hated us. Why? Because we went against his commandments,
right.
which was our heritage.
That's right.
Which is our heritage. And we refuse to acknowledge that and return back to our heritage. So God continually keeps us subject to payments, continually keeps us subject to captivity. continually, and it's never going to stop. The curse we serve is until we come back to the Lord.
Right.
Come on.
And they curse and to be subject to payments according to all the iniquities of our fathers.
So, yeah, you may not have served chattel slavery. You may not have been the one that went against God in the wilderness after coming out of Egypt the first time. However, because our forefathers are the Israelites, we still to this day fit the curses given to the Israelites.
Right.
We the Israelites, bro. That's who right. we are. You ain't no black man. You ain't no nigga. You a God and don't even know it. You a God. And I ain't just talking some cool SH to you neither, bro.
Right.
I'm telling you facts. You learn white man lies all your life, so that's why we kill each other.
Teach them.
That's why we hate each other.
Right, right.
We the gods on this earth.
That's
bro.
Right.
That's who we is, and we gonna take it back.
That's right.
We gonna, it's happening right before your eyes, and you don't even know it. You better come on, join us, bro.
Right.
You better come on, join us. Come on, read that again.
And they curse, and to be subject to payments
come on.
According to all the iniquities of our fathers.
Our fathers went against God. Our fathers sinned against our Lord.
Right.
Our fathers followed every god under the earth except our own. That's what our fathers did. Deuteronomy 28:15.
Bring it up.
What am I talking about? Whose fathers am I talking about? You blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans are the Israelites.
Right.
You fit the curses is how we know that.
Right.
Give me 15, jump down to 45.
Yes, sir. The book of Deuteronomy, chapter 28. Verse 15, but it shall come to pass if thou wilt not hearken unto the voice of the Lord thy God to observe to do all his commandments and his statutes which I command thee this day, that all these curses shall come upon thee and overtake thee.
The Bible say that curses are going to come upon the Israelites and overtake the Israelites. Come upon. Why would curses need to overtake us? Because once upon a time, we wasn't broke.
Right.
Once upon a time, we were a powerful nation. So it was hard for us to comprehend how the Lord would send us into captivity to any people. We ruled over all nations once upon a time, black man and woman. We were subject to no man. We were only subject to an invisible God.
Right.
Once upon a time. And that invisible God, we could see plainly. He showed himself to us every day.
That's right.
When we woke up to him, we went to sleep to him.
Right.
This is what we do. This is who we actually are. But we've been rocked to sleep.
That's right.
Why? Because we left off from our heritage, which is the commandments of the Most High God.
That's right.
We used to scream black power while Heron was pushed. But at the end of the day, nothing's in vain. IUIC has been given a vision. The tents of Judah has risen. Many has attempted the mission, minor murmuring, omitting, and missing the mark. Just reading that he had the flame of fire in his eyes gave us the spark. We on Paul's mission. We out on the road, purple and gold. From Mexico, Cuba, Haiti, Ghana, Sierra Leone. 144,000 boots banging, concrete crackling. These are how our men repented at heart. The scriptures is proof. IUIC, we deliver the truth.